I am sorry for coming a little bit late. I am developing a bit of a habit of going to bed a little
I
late.
am sorry for
Come
coming
on.
a little
But yeah, so I'm developing a little bit of a habit of kind of staying up a bit too late, getting to work on time, which is good, but it has the unfortunate consequence of making me very tired, and I have developed a habit of napping before I start streaming. And the problem with this is that I wind up streaming a little bit later and usually a bit shorter. But today we're actually going to try a newish game. It's called Breaking Wheel, and actually this is one that Jesse Quill got me in touch with. Hello, Jeff DeHeff, how are you doing? Let me take a minute here and open up the game. But yeah, so Jesse Quill was the one to sort of get me in touch with his game. It looks interesting, and actually, it's a very shrewd choice on her part. And I'll elaborate on this a little bit as I go through. But I want to take a quick minute and introduce the game because it's currently in early access. It did have an Indiegogo campaign, and I think even if this game maybe isn't your cup of tea, I actually think you may be interested in finding out a little bit more about its developer. And of course, I mean, again, it was Jess who got me in touch with it. It does mean that I got a key from the developer here. Whether or not this is something that you feel will make me particularly partial in my review, although I don't really plan on reviewing it. It's an early access game and I don't really do reviews. But I am going to explore the game. I usually don't like having these kinds of keys sitting in my library, unless there's one case where I was given a key for a game which I flat out did not enjoy at all. And I thought it would be slightly better to just let it pass by in silence rather than rather than open it up on stream and then just crap on it for an hour. So, how you doing, OCS1 Spectre? Good to see you again. So, Breaking Wheel, one thing that got my attention right off the bat was it's the Unreal logo in the corner. This game is a product of the Unreal Engine, and the reason why this is kind of an interesting point to me and why I think Jess was kind of very smart to draw this to my attention is that I had this game that I really enjoy called Slip, which is also a platformer made in 3D. I've actually done it on stream on two separate occasions, and I really enjoyed it both times. I'm generally not very good at these kinds of games, but they are quite compelling in their own little way. And so, I'm not necessarily going to just flat out say, oh, well, here's some other game you can spend your money on rather than Breaking Wheel. But rather, there's kind of this interesting. Once upon a time, if I had told you, what are the games being made by the. Oh! I forgot to. Jesse Quill, thank you very much for that host. I kind of. If you had asked me once upon a time, looking at the sorts of things coming out of the Unreal dev community, I would be hard pressed to point to any examples that were sort of serious games that weren't kind of first or third person shooters. Slip was one of these examples. Like, actually, this is a pretty fun platformer, really fast paced, very difficult, and great soundtrack. But it's kind of an indication in terms of how you can make a really good looking and creative little 3D platformer. So she's watched me play. She actually had a lot of fun watching me play it. Although I think she'll be the first to tell you she has no intention of actually trying out this game Slip. But I have a feeling that that might have motivated her to bring my attention to this game. And I think probably it was a smart call just because I suspect I fit this rather useful demographic for this game of people who like playing platformers like this but are quite bad at them. So this might also give you an idea if you're not a. I think if you're a diehard platformer, you'll probably have already made a decision about this game. Although if I can perhaps bring your attention to this a game that you haven't heard of, I will have served my purpose. But I don't know. It'll maybe for the rest of you, you'll get a chance to see whether or not this is a beast that you would like to try and mount. So I'm going to take a second here and read up on the Steam page. It does mean you're going to be without game audio, unfortunately, just because I'm out tabbed out of another window. I'll try and I'll maybe move. Let's see if I can maybe extend my screen. Yeah, here we go. I'll give you some music to listen to as I go through this. I might be slow to respond to chat though because of this. All right, so again, this game is in early access. Normally, that's a death sentence for me, but in this particular case, it's one that I, if it's a je recommendation from Jess, I'm usually gonna check it out. And like I said, it's neat because I haven't really played another game like this platformer I really enjoyed. So it was definitely one that I wanted to check out. I will, however, mention that, I don't really do reviews. I more talk about a game, I show it, I learn about it with you guys, and I'll happily answer questions, but I really don't know a lot about what makes games. Like, I couldn't tell you what makes a game a 5 out of 5 stars or a 4 out of 5 stars or something like that. Like, it seems very arbitrary. And more importantly, too, even though we'll learn from the description on the early access section, I have a feeling that this is a very good representation of kind of what the game will be like. I'm not going to be able to go back and alter my opinion. I actually think this is a problem. So Steam will, if I were to write a review on Steam, it would say, I got a code which I didn't pay for, and you can filter out my reviews. I think the default was to filter out reviews like that. And yet reviews made in early access, which may not be representative at all of the game, have no such filter. I wouldn't even have the option of clearing out reviews that would have been early on in the game's development, which I think is a really anti-developer kind of policy that Steam has. But there you have it. What the developers have to say about the game. Why early access? Breaking Wheel is almost feature complete. Early access gives us the chance to get some early feedback from the community before we release the final product. Hopefully, I will be kind of helpful in this regard. I don't really know what my feedback is worth. Approximately how long will the game be in early access? Release will be approximately in 2 or 3 months after early access. So this means that probably this is fairly representative of what the finished product is going to be like. All that on that note, how is the full version planned to differ from the early access version? For the final version, we want to improve the performance, improve the gamepad support and menus, implement multi-language support, German, French, Dutch, Finnish, Spanish, and Norwegian. So we've got something for Jesse Quill, Elkanoo, Leetoo, and Blågnti. I don't think I have any. Actually, I might even have some Norwegian viewers. Add more levels, add more skins, and fix all the bugs you guys find. What is the current state of the early access version? Breaking Wheel is almost feature complete, except for more levels and skins. We only have minor and cosmetic things that we want to address before release. Early access includes 35 levels, as bug tested as we can internally. 50 levels are planned for release. Early access includes 12 plus skins, 25 plus are planned for release. Early access also has mod support in the form of uncooked UE4 assets, Unreal Engine 4, and/or sources for free DLC. Will this game be priced differently during and after early access? No. And how are you planning on involving the community in your development process? While in early access, the community can create mods such as new skins or levels. We also want to improve the game based on the feedback that we get from the community. Thank you very much, Johnny Big Time, for that host. I will give you and Jesse Quill a shout out in a little bit, but I know my openings tend to drag a little bit. So if you could forgive me, I'll postpone the shout out for now, but I'm definitely looking forward to to talking about what a great dude you are. And welcome people from Johnny Big Time's chat. He must have been playing Rainbow Six Siege at this hour. All right, now, last thing I'll mention about this game, Breaking World is a 3D side-scrolling platformer. You control a wheel and have to collect as much coffee and coins as you can in more than 50 unique levels with a plethora of interesting gameplay mechanics. The basic game mechanics are quite simple. Roll left, roll right, jump, and collect as much coffee and coins as possible. Coffee will increase your movement speed and jump height. Coins are used to unlock bonus levels and new skins for your character. On top of that, we added mechanics like wall climbing, access switchers, enemies, and tons of traps and objects to make the game a little more interesting and challenging. Important note, Breaking Wheel currently requires 1 gig of free space on the C drive that builds at runtime. We are working on making this local, but so far no such luck as Unreal Engine likes to make all saves and app data. Sorry for the inconvenience. I only partially understand what that means, but it's a technical thing. Now, the reason why I wanted to take a little bit of time on Insane Mind Games and talk about this is, even if you are, let's say that you're kind of like, I'm not much of a platformer guy, and decide that it's not quite your thing, you might want to either follow that Twitter link that I had in my tweet for announcing the cast, or check out this developer, because their background is actually developing mods for Bethesda games. So this would be Skyrim and Fallout 4, and at least by their account, it's a... They make some of the top ones, like the ones that have been downloaded the most. Now, I'm not really big in Skyrim, and I don't own Fallout 4. I mean, I enjoy Skyrim in its own way. You guys have seen me play it. But I'm not so invested that I'm just downloading mods like crazy. I usually try to do it to maybe make it look a little bit better for the stream or something like that. But one thing that actually really appeals to me about this game, the fact that knowing that it was from a modding community, and the fact that they've made this DLC, you've got it right here, you can download the modding files. I love the fact that even in early development, they sort of stayed true to those roots, and I actually think it's a way that you will sort of see some differentiation for this product, and maybe where this game will come into its own. I mean, obviously, I'm going to assume that the developers have put some effort into the base game, but the fact that this thing continues to have a life and that there's people who are passionate about these kinds of games continuing to develop levels and skins and such, I think maybe gives it a little bit of a longer tail than, you know, some of the platformers where once you've played it, that's a little bit it. I mean, you can sort of say too, while Geometry Dash is a bit of a different beast, I actually think that's another decent model that you can sort of compare there. So on Steam, I checked, I don't think this is available on GOG, but this is available on Steam for Canada for $7.79, so I suspect it's probably around like $5 US or something like that. Jeff DeHeff says, it just means that temporary files are very large and that hidden app data location is not very accessible by default, which is inconvenient if you want to uninstall the game because you have to know where to look to remove it completely. Thank you very much, Jeff DeHeff. That actually clears up the part that I was not clear on. Thank you for linking that, Jessequel. All right. So again, definitely check out the developer, especially if you're one of the Fallout. Well, you've probably already seen their stuff in the Nexus mod community. But it's definitely one that it's an interesting little bit of a background. So I suppose without further ado, we should see what Breaking Wheel looks like. One thing I'll just do for the settings, there's multiple composers. So there's a side of me that says I should do random, but I don't think I'm going to know what composer is going. So how about for each level we do, we'll cycle through each of the composers. How's the volume, by the way? I'm hoping everything's good, that you guys can hear the game. It might be a little quiet, actually. I did the beginning of the tutorial level, but I'm actually going to do this again, just so you guys can sort of see the story. In the meantime, let me tell you about Jess. Actually, you know what? If I start shouting out Jess and the game starts loading, that's going to be really bad. So how about when I complete each level, I'll do a shout out. It was a beautiful day in the village of Wheel. The residents were just getting up and making their morning rounds. Breaking Wheel had just finished its morning coffee and biscuits. It was bound to be another lazy day in the peaceful village. Or was it? Thank you. here I am, the wheel. Now, one thing I'm curious, good morning, breaking wheel. One thing I'm not clear about is if the breaking refers to the fact that the wheel is in disrepair, which doesn't seem to be the case, or the fact that it's kind of got these gaps in between. If it's a breaking wheel, as in the torture and execution, or let's call it what it is, murder, like the breaking on the wheel, in which case it's either, you know, cute and unusual, or oh my god, that's horrifying. Now again, one thing I really love on the 3D side of things is just, you know, it's a really good looking game. I suspect there's probably quite a bit of material here that has been made for their Skyrim stuff on display here, but I'm not going to complain about it. It's good looking. All right. Breaking wheel. I'll get those repairs done for you today.
Oh, I used to be an adventurer like you.
Do you hear that? Hear what? Run! Hello. Ah! We've got you covered, breaking wheel. Head inside. A short while later. What will we do? I don't know. Now, this is one of the things that kind of got my attention on the game coming up. So, taking advantage of sort of the depth, they took the princess. The monsters assaulted our village. They stole all our gold. They kidnapped the princess. And worst of all, they stole all our coffee. Who will volunteer to fight for us? Very brave, breaking wheel. Before you depart, go see Robin. He should be down in the armory. Godspeed, breaking wheel. So, like I was talking, I really like this feature of the sort of like the tilt sort of taking advantage of the third dimension, so it's not just that, you know, Unreal's brought in to make the thing look beautiful and whatnot. Before I go a little bit further in the plot, it's actually, there's a love-hate thing I have with one aspect of this game so far, and that's actually the story. It's one thing where I was kind of like, I was really on the fence about whether or not I wanted to cover this because of it, because, you know, the wheel as a main character is kind of like, well, is this just because they didn't have, you know, any models, or could they not get like some good animations for the main character, so they went with like a geometrically simple object to portray? And the idea of a wheel running by and collecting its stolen coffee kind of falls under that category of, oh my god, isn't this game so zany? I'm having a good time now. Like, I was a little annoyed when I heard that as a plot point. But that's also extreme. The reason I'm saying this off the top is that I actually think that's an extremely unfair criticism on a game which really should be weighed on its merits as a platformer, right? I mean, at what point, so like Meat Boy, oh, he's made of meat, well, I don't like that. Like, just because I'm a bit of a killjoy on some of the zaniness of game ideas doesn't necessarily mean that they're bad games. But I think one of the biggest things is that I'm going to suspect that my reaction isn't... by the way, there's timers on these levels, so that's why I'm spending all this time in the tutorial. Also, I get to show you just how good it looks when you move to and from light sources, hey? Getting some good air on this. But yeah, so it's one of these things where I'm going to suspect that my reaction is not going to be unique. I suspect that there's probably going to be a few people who might otherwise have enjoyed the game who sort of, again, judge the book by the cover and don't really give it a chance. And I will actually say, you know, while I just spent that time sort of complaining a little bit about the wheel getting its lost coffee, I will admit, the first time I saw the moment where everybody backs off and leaves you to volunteer, I actually laughed a bit at that. I don't know if Breaking Wheel is actually being brave and volunteering for this, or if he just kind of got screwed by his colleagues, but I prefer to think the latter. Yeah, exactly, Jesse Quill. Like, I mention it because it's something to me that, well, GG chat, I think I just lost the tutorial. I don't think there's getting out of this. Okay, first recommendation to developers. Don't let me do this or put an Easter egg back here. I think I have to restart the level. or we'll enjoy the soundtrack. Yes, congratulations, guys. Like I said, I'm part of the special demographic where it's I play platformers that, that I'm no good at. Okay, let's restart it. I won't read the dialogue again, but yeah, so I wanted to kind of get that out of the way to let you know, if anything, so I mentioned the fact that I do have a key from from the devs on this, but it doesn't actually mean that I'm well disposed towards the game, let's say. I actually started off with a fairly unfair and fairly I don't know how to put it, pessimistic view. But I will say, I do like the way that the game actually uses the 3D space in the form of those switches. So, anyways, I will get on with a little bit of the gameplay. Actually, now that I think of it, I don't think I should be hearing my movement sounds, shouldn't I? There we go. Again, I'm missing my my grounding sounds. I don't think I'm gonna restart the level for this, but let's just see. Oh, now I've gone and done it. Oh, cool! It does actually give us it does give us the tracks. In that case. I'm liking the music so far, but let's do random because I can see which soundtrack it is. I'm wondering if it would be nice to have an option to hit space or something like that to get past the dialogue. I do what I want. No. All right. I'm getting inconsistent wheel sounds. They stole all our gold. This is horrible. A hero type, huh? If you want different armor, you need to bring me gold. Where's your sense of patriotism, sir? Not like it does anything. It's only cosmetic anyway. Don't sell yourself short. I like your wheel. You better be on your way then. Wait a minute, did the king just send me into an advertising? Have fun saving us all, I guess. Oh, you just don't care anything about... you don't care about anything, armorer, but I know deep down you're an old softy. Hey, Insane Mind Games, how you doing? Oh, I really appreciate that. I've actually been casting for half an hour on the tutorial, so I don't think you're missing much, but I really do appreciate it. Guys, we have the developer inside the room. Be nice. There's actually 40 tracks in the... Oh, cool. And so did our hero venture out into parts unknown. The fate of the small village resting solely on their axle. I completed the beginning after two tries. With a score of 0. Johnny Big Time, I believe the person who does communications might be a m'lady, if I'm not mistaken. you corrected. Anyways, welcome, Insane Mind Games. I mean, again, I'm going to be learning this alongside you guys, but if you have any pressing questions, such as the autoload files that come up at the start, they can tell you about it. All right. So, before I jump into the tutorial level, let's get a couple of quick shoutouts, though. Yeah, no problem. Actually, this is a great time for me to do these these shoutouts then. So, guys, Jesse Quill is the wonderful caster who got me in touch with this game. I'm actually really grateful that she did, because another big thing I like about platformers are ones with nice soundtracks. Thanks, John. Jesse Quill is one of my dearest friends on Twitch. It's very easy to see why she has had the success that she's had on the, Twitch, and her success has translated into doing a lot of interesting work. She is somebody who makes connections both with developers and with streamers such as myself. She does a really good job of bridging that gap. And this is a perfect example right here, that she's somebody who's got me in touch with a game that I would have ignored on Steam otherwise. And to give you guys a chance to maybe see if this is your kind of thing, and more importantly, if it's my kind of thing. Again, rather than being one of these people who's just kind of like, well, it's just getting people keys, right? How hard is that? She's actually somebody who thinks quite hard about the types of games that people like. I don't think most of you would have pegged me as a platform player, and yet she took an experience of playing another Unreal Engine style platformer and sort of made this very good recommendation for me. So I definitely owe her for getting me hooked up with this. I'm very happy to give this the time in the sun, and I hope I won't be too unfair to the title. But more importantly, too, if you guys want to see how casting actually works, if you want to see an absolute sweetheart of a human being and somebody who takes all of that empathy and all of that ability to connect with people and put that right up on the screen, I can make no higher recommendation than Jessie Quill. She's been playing a lot of Dead by Daylight recently. She was doing some of the Walking Dead lately as well, and I'm trying to convince her to play the WoW of Warcraft again, but I kind of mostly just want to live vicariously through her instead of actually pay for Legion. Now, as far as... I got almost all the major bugs fixed in 5 days. Can't type have volume. Oh, yes, absolutely insane, my gate. Well, speaking of WoW, I was just doing these shout-outs thinking that you weren't available. But yeah, please, by all means, don't feel obligated to to speak to my nonsense. I'm camless, so I gotta keep talking or I die just like a shark. Not to be outdone, we have got the inimitable Johnny Big Time playing some Rainbow Six Siege a little bit earlier, and hopefully Jess will shout herself out as well as... at the same time, that's really funny. But yeah, Johnny Big Time is an outstanding... I would actually go so far, I don't say this lightly, he is a one-of-a-kind caster. He is really, really friendly. He is... Again, I hate the fact that I repeat this so many times. Oh, come on, Jess, shout yourself. Oh, you did shout yourself out. My apologies. He has got smack talking down to an art. I can remember making some terribly crude jokes in his Dragon's Dogma stream about his chances with a certain Duke's daughter. He is just a ton of fun, and he actually announced some secret plans for his stream coming up in February, and I am really excited to see him sort of kick his cast up to another level, because he's one of these great examples of a caster who just tirelessly works. I've never really seen him put on a bad cast. He's done like Dragon's Dogma, he's done Dark Souls, he's done Rainbow Six Siege. He also does some things a little bit off the beaten track, so he got Chaos Reborn, and actually I still need to play a game with him of that. But basically, he's somebody who kind of every game he touches turns to gold. He always finds the fun inside of it, and he's just an absolute sparkling personality. He's a really outstanding guy, and he's one of my favorite people. I mean, there's two people who are probably my favorite shoutouts, and it's Jessie Quill, and I think all of you already know way too much about her at this point here. But Johnny Big Time is another guy who I love shouting out because I love seeing his community grow. I love seeing people discover his cast. I love seeing his cast grow. I love seeing him develop as a caster. And he's just such a great guy to be around. So he's somebody who I always have to take the time to shout out, whether it's a short one or a larger one. Anyways, on to the tutorial level. When in trouble, hang on. Every level there is a chicken that's hard to get. Bring it to the end without getting hit for bonus points. So this is one feature I always like in platformers like this. They kind of show you the nature of the beast. You get to view the preview. You mean for carrying Johnny Big Time or for... or at the end. By the way, Johnny Big Time is a chef by profession, so if you... I think he wants to know whether or not he can put that chicken in a pot. Well, tell you what, Johnny, I think I will show you. Alright, you know... we're going to see this in the tutorial anyway. So I have 2.5 minutes to complete it. Collect coffee to increase your movement speed and jump height. Jump on chests or ump on chests to open them and obtain coins. Collect coins to unlock new skins or bonus levels. The faster you complete a level, the more time bonus you will get. If the time is up, you get minus points. All right, avoid getting hit by traps or you'll lose coffee and coins. So this is where I always lose my time. Oop, there we go. My time priority. Some walls can be climbed. While climbing, press jump. Wait a minute. Press jump to jump off the wall. Off the wall. There we go. Okay, I didn't know that actually. I should be reading this. Spring platforms launch you relative to their angle. Well, first I'm gonna get some replacement coins because I am garbage at jumping. I'm also garbage at the platforms, it seems. Watch out for objects flying in your direction, like those. Again, I love the use of depth in this game. Sometimes it's better to slow down than... what was it? To move a bit slower. Oh god! Oh god, this is a disaster! Alright, let's just suicide out. Never gonna get that. I've done this two times now, three times now, and I always get nailed on those spikes. And I've actually seen the developers on their Greenlight video do this level and know how it's supposed to be done. I think that message is put there specifically knowing that you're gonna go crashing into it. Some traps will only trigger when you become close enough. Be wary. Be cautious. Can't outwheel the wheel, my friends. There are many other traps and combinations waiting for you. Is that a threat? There are different ways to approach problems. Be observant. This, incidentally, is a big one for me. Mistakes were made! Any game that bothers to take the time in designing its levels so that I can approach it in a few different ways is a good one in my books. Oh, Christ. All right, well, all that careful effort to get that coffee was for naught. Fans will push you up relative to their angle. Be careful if the fan blades are exposed. Oh, there's the chicken. Incidentally, I believe... the fans also behave differently based on your angle. So let's, I'm gonna hop down for this coffee and just see what I can... Ooh! See if we can do something about this, chicken. Oh, Christ almighty. Nope! I'm just wasting coins, but... Oh, Jesus! Alright. I got the chicken last time, but I have no idea what to do with it, so... Complete the tutorial level. And hit jump right before... Oh, run to the fan from the... right... platform... sorry, I think probably I missed the context on the comment inside my games, but... Anyways, we still got the time bonus. And now we're doing levels I've never seen before. I didn't forget Johnny Big Time, I abandoned the chicken. That chicken can fend for itself. It's not gonna learn to... Oh, hello. Oh god. So immediately this game has punished me several times for just running in like an idiot. Alright. Levels are not designed to be 100% right off. It's more getting used to everything than come back and try them again. Absolutely. I think I'm probably wasting my time if I try to 100% stuff in platformers anyway, but... These are really good looking levels. Ooh, there we go. Also, one thing that I didn't quite... So I was originally thinking, it's like, well, how do I decide what... I was trying to think... was that coffee worth it, breaking wheel? Jesus. I was trying to decide, you know, how I know to climb up a wall, but it's very obvious if it's a, I think I need to just commit to a jump. It's kind of obvious based, you know, if it's an ice wall, you've got, you can dig into that. I think the previous wall was like cork or something like that. So I kind of like how the textures just, it shows rather than tells. And I haven't ever been confused in terms of being able to go up a wall or not. Oops. This is what I get for reading chat. All right, but we're still alive, so that's what matters. Probably your favorite part of this game. Oh, that's really cool. By the way, I want to say again, Insane Mind Gaze, thanks for stopping by. It's one thing for me to kind of just flail around like an idiot in a game like this. Whether or not this represents your product particularly well, I suppose, is another question. Jesus. It's actually really cool to hear a little bit about what you guys are thinking of in terms of the future of the game as well. I'm out of coffee. Let's see if I can do this. Ooh. Oh, right. I also have gold that I can get by with. I think I've got what I need here. Oh, hang on. These levels are actually a lot bigger than I thought they would be. This is another thing that... So one of the things I was talking about at the beginning was how I have a little bit of a... I suppose a tenuous relationship with platformers. I enjoy them, but I'm not a connoisseur by any means. And so one of the things that I always sort of think of whenever I see a new platformer on... I wonder if I can get a view of the other side. Like this. Nope. Let's try this again. No, it just looks like it's those couple of angles. Okay, so I gotta find a way to turn here. So I was just trying to... Whenever I see a platformer like this on Steam, the first thing that I always sort of think of is how... Oh, wait, I think I know what I need to do. It's showing me in the background. Say, how do you differentiate it from all the other ones? When there's a Super Meat Boy in Steam, why buy that? If there's, I'm not going to name all the other platformers that you can get. But, what's the way that I can say, oh, you like platformers, here's, you gotta try Breaking Wheel. Two things that immediately caught my attention after playing this level, and I mean, this is obviously the first full one that I go through, is I really like how big the levels are. I kind of thought they'd be a little bit more like the tutorial, which is a bit more linear, and as it should be, right? It's a tutorial. But the other thing that really got my attention was it feels like there's a lot of care and a lot of thought that's been put into these levels. So, I'm having a little difficulty orienting myself as like, oh God, what, how do I collect all the coffee? And I'm like, well, maybe I won't worry about 100%ing, as we said in chat. And then you could see the thought process. I find, this door opening, which has been introduced at the start of the level. Good placement. Didn't have to come up with some text to say, hey, dumbass, here's how you open doors. I wouldn't have progressed through the level if I didn't do that. And you can sort of see me. It's like, okay, I sort of understand what I need to do. I need to go up this ramp to exit the level, but how do I get myself on the correct plane in order to move that? And as I was going on the rotation, I see what I need to do exactly in the background. I love moments like that in games. And I mean, we're able to do it with a small time bonus. So, I'm liking this. Although I don't think we've had any music from one of the other artists yet. I might do a manual override if we have to. All right. I have a feeling this is lulling me into a false sense of security. Oh, damn it! Oh, God! M swaps tracks. Oh, cool. Thanks. So we are listening to Evolution by Paul. Oh, this level's too easy. As I whack myself three times with the axe. Hello? Oh god! Maybe a better question in Sane Mind Games, is this level easy for a moron? Alright. Ah! Ah! Alright. Let me through, you fool. Even when I try, I hit the... I wonder if I should just be able to ram that. My guess is... Well, it looks like I have to. From the other side. Nice little pointer saying, hey idiot, you gotta go down here. Ali. Go for that last coffee? No. Gonna lose it anyway. Alright. So if it's pointing me here, there's something for the exit that I'm missing. God, I am bad at these games. Well, so much for time. Christ almighty. You realize the whole... we realize he made the game whole game too hard because it requires thought. Wait till you see the boss. I didn't know there were boss fights. Well, now I'm obligated to... Alright. I'm... There we go. One of you guys loves Dark Souls too much. I'm okay with something inspired by Dark Souls. Christ. All right, so if I'm supposed to launch off this thing, nope. Oh. Probably, yeah. But yeah, so I mean, I don't necessarily think requiring thought is a bad element. You're probably being sarcastic with the sticking out tongue. But yeah, the big one for me was actually the fact that, you know, I sort of looked through the level on Frozen Ruins that revealed the exit to me. That was actually quite appealing. But again, I probably just showed what a complete nerd I am. I'm apparently one of these people who, like, you know, somebody will come up to me and be like, oh, hey, how's it going? And I think they're asking, like, it's a question that's asking for information. So, you know, realize when I made the game too hard because it requires thought, and I immediately turn around and give a treatise on thought in video games. Sorry, chat. It's dangerous to go alone. Take this. Left mouse button to swing weapons? Oh god. Is there a way to not use a mouse button? You know, if I'd paid attention, I would have seen. Alright, well, this is going to... Alright, well, you know, I'll just start playing with my left hand and whacking it. Yeah, no worries. Get wrecked, Spider-Man. Ah! You know who I really want to see play this? Elkanu. I have a feeling his screams and cries of pain. Am I left-handed? I am not Johnny Big Time, but I don't have any problems using. It's actually when I worked in film and I like usually whenever I was like passing off lenses or something like that, I would usually be asked if I was left-handed. And it's just there's certain tasks that I don't particularly mind performing with my offhand. I'm not ambidextrous by any stretch of the imagination. I don't think I have enough coffee to make this work, but we'll give it a try. I noticed Jesse Coyle, and I have a feeling that is probably your doing. Yeah, I will actually mention, so you probably already heard the the fact that I think the world of Jess. Jesus Christ. But I would definitely say I was actually Jess is absolutely the reason I'm playing this right now. She's the type of I guess is it influencer manager? Code puncher? Whatever the hell you call yourself, Jess. She's absolutely the kind of person who, if she makes a game recommendation, I actually put the time into checking it out. It's mostly because I actually feel like she's bothered to put the time into kind of looking at what I like to play. She obviously used a little bit of private information about me to recommend this one. But I've definitely got some people on my who send me emails, and it's just like, okay, so I sort of understand that I'm on your B team, that, you know, when there's like a mobile game that you want to cover, it's kind of like, oh, I'm so glad they're paying attention to me. And I generally don't have a very high opinion of the games, and I usually just kind of ignore the emails. But I can't think of a recommendation that Jess hasn't, or I can't really think of a recommendation that Jess has made where I haven't opened the email, I haven't taken a look at what's going on, and obviously I'm a little slow in covering this. This is just because, you know, Christmas and work and whatnot. But I think it actually matters a lot when you have somebody who you can sort of rely on knowing that they sort of know your stuff, like what you like to do. And some of my favorites have usually been when Jess kind of takes something that I don't normally stream, but just sort of says, like, you know, I think this is in the spirit of what you like to cover. Oh god, we are this chicken's gonna be very lost. Actually, one thing that really interests me about a difficulty curve for this game, I guess what I'm trying to say is I really like Jess. Don't you dare fire breathe me, spider. Oops. Sorry, I was going to say something about the game that completely flew out of my head. My apologies. It's a hobby, you don't mind what titles people give it. I don't know, I like Code Puncher. You know, the more exploring I do, the higher a chance I lose this chicken. Although I noticed the traps seem to be a little less absent, so I'm wondering if this is more of a level that's about up as I. They got me. I was just gonna say, I wonder if this is a little bit more about introducing enemies. It is not. That was sabotage. Question answer, Johnny. All right. Well, I really want to know what this thing is. Ah, coins. Get me out of here. Sacre bleu! Actually, I think I can Elkanu this. Oh! No, 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 no! That was a fun level. Try modding a level and torture your friends with it. Oh god, this would be a good stream idea. To come up with do a stream where I make a level for this, but I'm not really creative. I should do streams where I impersonate other streamers. Enjoy your breakfast! That is Johnny's catchphrase, if you want, in case you didn't know, guys. I should make a Patreon or like a website and like remove all of the Creative Commons attributions, because that's what professionals do, and put as my catchphrase, enjoy your breakfast. You'd be okay with that, right, Johnny? Sorry, guys, I'm probably not talking enough about the game here, but I'm wallowing in it. I've gone from kind of like cautious skepticism to, all right, this is actually very engrossing. Huh? The game speaks for itself. Well, what use am I? It's not like you're here for my appearance. Oh, chicken, I am so sorry I got you here. Listen, if you've got anybody you're mad at and, like, you kind of regret it and you want to apologize to them, now would be a great time to do that. All right, well, not getting out of that. You're only here for my appearance, Melee Mage. How are you doing, my friend? Jess, could I get a shout out for Melee Mage? I got a chance to watch him play Final Fantasy after. Like, I was kind of like, well, I guess, you know, he must be really busy. I haven't seen him stream for a while, and next thing I know, it's like, wait, why am I not following Melee Mage? So. Alright. This music is entirely too cheery for what's about to happen to this chicken! We made it to learn, so as we learned, we got better. Actually, yeah, so I was talking a little bit about, the coffee thing. So presumably the people who want to 100% this game, I feel like I'm missing something very obvious on where to progress with this level. I just don't want to, like, throw myself down some random hole in hopes that I find something, because every time I pass that blade, I'm playing with that chicken's life, and I'm his protector. I am the chicken born. But yeah, one of the things that I kind of like is that I notice that I lose control a little bit more with the more coffee that I have. So I think the closer you get to 100%ing a level, the more challenging it can become. All right, so the coffee is a bit of an indicator there that I'm... let's not worry about jumping to it. Let's... Ooh! That's a hard target. I think I have to... Well, chat, as we always like to say here, you only YOLO once. For freedom! Alright, maybe not. But yeah, so I love this idea of kind of this mechanic inside the game that kind of makes it just naturally more difficult the closer you get to proing it out. As for me, I'm gonna just struggle with hitting my targets. Oh, Christ almighty, I would have had that. Enter cameras giveaway level progress. Yeah, I've been trying to maybe do that on like the second pass. I'm missing that coffee every time. Alright. I think there's, for me at least, because again, I don't, I mean, let's face it, this is not a skill-based stream. There's a little bit of enjoyment that I get out of trying to figure out a game or a level or something like that. So I figure if I see the level ahead of time, I'm I'm kind of denying myself that chance of exploring a little bit. Also, I've got a terrible memory, so there we go. Hell, cute. All right, Clucker Doodle. You know what? I'm not gonna throw your life away so recklessly. I am absolutely throwing your life away so recklessly. I cannot speak tonight. I'm so sorry, guys. By the way, since when did I started calling? Oh, I'm so sorry, chicken. All right. Well, you know what? Seeing as I have free resources to waste on these spikes. Oh, Jesus Christ. All right. Johnny Big Time has already named our chicken friend. You made each and every cam, you try not to show any actual secrets. Okay. I keep banging my, I guess I can't really call this the head, but the top of the wheel on this thing, and it always throws me off. Ooh. Oh, Jesus Christ, why did I do that to myself? I had so much fun with all that jumping that I just had to... Coffee increases max speed, acceleration, jump height doesn't increase your speed over acceleration, deceleration, so yes, on the ground you become harder to control. In the air, however, your control goes up drastically with coffees, which allows you to make some levels phenomenally harder with more coffee or phenomenally easier. Speaking of air control... Well, you know, the one thing I'd say here in Sane Mind Games, I'm not 100% sure if that... if this lip is deliberately that hard to get to, but the speed of the spikes is not so much of a big deal for me as it is the fact that it requires almost surgical precision to hit that ledge, and it's so easy to just bang my head on the top. Anyways, we have another opportunity. Alright friends, I'm taking a quick look at the time. We've got about an hour of this game under our belt. Of course, 20 minutes of it is just me rambling on about things that the world doesn't care about. You trust me, don't you, chicken? But I would love, and I suspect Insane Mind Games might be interested in hearing what your guys' impressions of Breaking Wheel is. Problem is, your rule is to make every normal level beatable with zero coffee, so every jump that is required to finish has to be done with a normal jump. Hardcore levels, your dicks. What about kid mode? Alright, so I think... Okay, let's just see if I can... I'll abandon the coffee if I can. And let's see if we can give this chicken a safe passage. Alright, we're making progress. Oh, I'm so sorry, chicken, but you died for the greater good. So you're making an MLP skin that you're forced to use in kid mode for free. Oh, chicken, I'm so sorry. You were so close to freedom. Yeah, this is another thing that I really like about the game, or games like this, is you get to see yourself. I don't know if any. So I'm happy you're finding stuff. If these are new things you're discovering, my apologies if it's annoying whenever I read out the typos. But again, I know for a lot of people the tendency on this is to have it on in the background. They don't always watch some of the visuals. And this one, I think they have a reason to. It's actually a really nice looking game. But I tend to notice if I speak out a typo, it's usually noticed a little bit more. No. I'll give you an example. Same mind. Hey, Randall. 10 chickens out of 10. So, ump on chests to open them to obtain coins, and there was one other one here. Alright, I get to have revenge. Oh yes, MLG. Some walls can be climbed while pressing jump to jump of the wall instead of off the wall. And those are the only two typos I found so far. Oh, and loot. Yeah, actually, I don't even notice all of them. Oh, excellent, Randall, welcome. I am actually pretty terrible at platformers. I am only in this game's target demographic in the sense that it's a good game, and I think there's room for more good games. But I am absolutely garbage at platformers, and I have a surly and generally unfavorable temperament and disposition. Welcome to the worst camless cast on Twitch. But the game makes up for it. Well, we do what we can here, Johnny Big Time. Alright, I swear I'm gonna get the chicken this time. You know, I wonder. Yeah, there we go. Freedom! Oh, that's really funny, Insane Mind. Cool thing that you think you did was by the time you get to the first boss, you'll probably be really good at control and able to start 100%ing levels. Yeah, well, I mean, as you can see here, right, from the previous, from a previous attempt on the tutorial, that was a pretty substantial improvement. So, and I mean, you can see it in the scores too. So, all right. On to the Ancient One. Yeah, who has a scar? What? Oh, cool. All right. Again, I'm a stubborn man, so we're not getting a preview. What's the worst that can happen down in this fiery area? Ah! If you want cheats, he can give them to you too. Oh, that's a great question, Randall. I'm not much of a mobile gamer, so I never think to ask that, but that is a... Probably there was a sword somewhere I could have picked up, but... You have no chance check. Oh my god, there's so many of these. You're pretty sure that casts using cams are the worst camless casters? Is that the only standard to which you're holding me, Jess? Everybody, I would like to announce that my new favorite caster is Johnny Big Time. Doesn't betray me and break my heart like one. Also, some of your levels will never make it to mobile because of the mechanics. You guys didn't see that clip, or that clip, or that clip. Probably when you go full release, then console, then start working on mobile. I think that's smart. I mean... Streamer has an opinion on game development. Oh god, I never would have imagined, but I have something of a... I don't know if I can call it a preference, but definitely a little bit more of a... Well, this is complicated. I have a feeling this is almost intentional, too. But definitely I like the idea of specialization. So a great example of this would be Paul Kilduff Taylor's company, Mode 7 Games, where they did Frozen Synapse, Frozen Cortex, and now they're doing Frozen Synapse 2. So that was a PC game. I think it was inspired by a Julian Gollop game called Laser Squad. And... So they did that, then they brought Frozen Synapse to iPad, and I believe they actually tried to take Frozen Synapse to the iPhone as well, and I think their impression was that basically nobody bought it on iPhone. But the nice thing here, right, is that the game is made, it's, you know, it's good, it's as good as it's ever going to be, and then... you know, expands out. So I can sort of see a logical development to console because, I mean, I'm being stubborn and not playing it with a controller, but very clearly this game lends itself well to a controller. But the more I'm playing it, I think I kind of understand. I don't know, I'm not entirely sure how I'd do some of the stuff on a phone. But then I don't develop games, so, you know, there you have it. Unreal doesn't support some of the things you did for mobile, and that, and you'd light up the phone like it was a Galaxy 6. Alright. I want to know when this boss starts showing up. On the phone, you're thinking of holding one side of the screen to move and tap for jump. Weapons will be... Oh, that's actually a fun idea. Now, one thing I didn't check before is if I can jump on an enemy to damage them. I cannot. That's uncalled for, sir. See ya. If I type 8675, oh. Holy hell. Why did I stop on that? 8675309, I will get five. Now, is the number a reference to something that I'm missing? 8675309. Wait, in a loop. 8675309. Ah, there we go. Hey, booty snagglers. I'm sure he's just a disgruntled postal worker. Ah. Yeah, sorry, I don't go outside much. I don't get... I rely on Jess to kind of inform me of what the Ute today is into. Mind you, she just likes that, like, Star Trek series. Like, with the Planet of the Teddy Bears and the Space Cowboy. And the Space Hairdresser. All right, I'm on the good side. I'm okay at avoiding a pit of spiders. Actually, no, I'm terrible at avoiding the pit of spiders. I always go in the pit of spiders, but I'm good at escaping the pit of spiders. No such luck. What is this game? Oh, good. Yes, excellent point, Inside Man Games. That's... Oh god, I am so sorry, chicken. What did you... You know, I feel like I gotta go Fight Club on this chicken and just ask him, like, what would you want to do before you died or something like that as I hurtle him towards his inevitable death. Oh, Jesus! That was wasteful, that was. And get different wheels. Yeah, actually, maybe we should load up a wheel skin just for the benefit of those... Okay, so I'm supposed to be able to beat every level without, coffee and normal. Oh. I believe... No, I'm not stuck. So Booty Snagglers, this is an early access game, although I'd say it's probably... In terms of what you'll... Oh, you know what? I'm just jumping too early, that's why. So this is a 3D platformer by Insane Mind Games, who you may have noticed is currently watching this stream, probably while covering their eyes and peeking through them. So far as I can tell, it had an Indiegogo campaign. It was voted up through Steam Greenlight, which is a... I don't know if it's a Byzantine process, I just don't understand, or if it's just... I don't know how to describe Steam Greenlight. It's a very strange beast. Anyways, it made it through the gauntlet, and it's by... Again, I rely on... I rely on the good faith and the forbearance of the developer if I misrepresent them. But I believe a team of very talented Skyrim and Fallout modders who have turned their mind to higher aspirations and have made a 3D game in which a wheel rolls around, picks up coffee, gets whacked by axes, and makes me realize that I'm not very good at video games. All right, now I've got my serious face on.
Freedom!
All right, so Insane Mind Games actually did a very good job of describing everything that's wrong with Steam Greenlight. I don't think I've played Trials. Hello, troll. Oh, all right then. He's got some range on him. Suffice to say, I'm quite glad that I've got an insane number of coins. Maybe I'll even have some of them by the end. Too strong. Next game you are storyboarding is an open world RPG because you know how to do the I don't know, I think you got so this is probably a terrible question to ask, but like I'm assuming you guys are happy with this finished product. I mean it's I would say I would be extremely proud to show somebody something like this in my own case, but then my standards may be a little bit lower than somebody who has done who's done development on some very successful mods in the past. But one thing I will say about the game, I mean, I really don't know what the economics of a platformer on Steam are, just because, again, it seems like the sort of thing that just about anybody feels like they could make. But very few people can do well, and I think the tendency for people to make, you know, for lack of a better term, bullshit, and dump it onto the Steam store has got to make it difficult for a game like this to stand out. But I mean, I think people who've been here from the start, we've probably been casting for about an hour and a half now, can sort of say how I went from maybe an initial skepticism to, get wrecked, troll. Or sorry, to use the Johnny-ism. Gotcha, bitch! Yeah, it's, I think it's a really solid game. Has too much HP because Malt is a sadist. You're pretty proud of it. Have a ton of new things coming for the last 15 and some fun bonus levels. Not great, and an open world is looking like you'll sink 10 to 15 grand into it and then pray for 400k Kickstarter to work. Its early access sales are still under 200. Your main goal was just to learn what you wanted to be done in November, but your perfectionist is sticking by your goal. I mean, and same, I have a lot of respect for it, because I mean, if you think of this too, like the amount of kind of like pump and dump style early access games, right, where they don't have a lot of success early on, and so all of a sudden, like, the people who were early adopters are left holding the bag, is, like, it's the reason I more or less overlook most early access stuff. And it kind of, I mean, again, it kind of drains it out. Like, obviously, this game has a few hurdles to overcome in terms of me getting some attention to it. So, with that in mind, guys, how many people do we have watching right now? 7. So... if you guys like seeing games like this, it is worth mentioning that they need lifeblood. They need to be supported. All right. Wait a minute. Let's unlock some skins. All right, chat. We can unlock... oh, we can't unlock the Wheel of Duty. I'll go through...
our fashion row, probably cheapest. I'll do it the way that I read menus. I'll like right to left. But yeah, if you guys do enjoy something like this, do consider supporting the developer. We should actually probably have a link. Sorry, Jess, I'm gonna play the bastard streamer and like, good mods, could I get a link to the Steam page? Obviously, there's a lot of games with some demands on your time, but and your wallet. But if this does seem like something you want to pick up, at least I suppose if we can't turn that into a sale, and I mean, obviously, it's up to you to decide whether or not the combination of price and game is worth it for you. But if it is something you think that's interesting, and it's something that you'd maybe like to kind of consider in the future, that or wait to see it outside of early access, although I think it's a fairly good representation of what the game looks like or will be like at the end, and of course we've got a promise of some extra stuff in the oncoming levels, definitely at least consider putting it in your wish list. One thing that I will point out in terms of putting it in your wish list, it does have, at least for me, I notice when I see people putting games on their wish list, I click on it. And if one of the hurdles that this game is facing is a saturated market of platformers, then having somebody that you know wishlist it or follow it or just otherwise sort of show some kind of indication of interest, that's going to mean that very, you know, subtly without any kind of cost to you, you know, the people who you're following, people who are on your friends list, are then going to be able to look at it. And I think really the best thing that a game will ask for is an opportunity to sort of show itself to you. Try and say, you know, this is what I'm about. Let me know if you're interested. But I mean, I hadn't heard about it if Jess hadn't. I wouldn't have heard about it unless Jess brought it to my attention. And I suspect you guys may not have necessarily seen it if I hadn't streamed it. So if there's something that we can do in terms of making sure that this game finds its audience, I think at the very least following the game, wishlisting it, if it's something that you'd be interested in picking up. I mean, maybe somebody will wind up buying it for you if you've got a birthday or some kind of celebration coming up. These are some ways that the developer... I mean, money is money for a developer, right? So if you... even if you're not the one to actually do the purchase, but if it's something that you would enjoy and you put inside of that wishlist, you kind of never know what comes up. Anyways, sorry guys. Your early access price is on point with what the game offers in early access. You're planning on pumping it to $9.99 and giving a 30% launch discount. Oh, I'm just trying to think how that would work. I mean, I think I was under the impression that the early access thing said that the price wasn't going to change. But then, I mean, that I'm not entirely sure that becomes something that you have to marry yourself to. I mean, obviously, if you're putting the time... I mean, your guys' time is valuable, right? So I think it's... especially if you've got some big plans for the remaining levels, I think the extra... This is the other thing, too, is like... we had Brigador as one of the streamers... Sorry, guys, I will get back to some gameplay, but this is an interesting conversation to me, at least. Like, we had Brigador come in. That's a great game, by the way, too. And... I can't remember how many people were... I can't remember what the price was. I think it was like $20 or like $25 or something like that. And you had this mob of people doing something like, you know, this isn't a $20 game. This is more like a $15 game or something like that. You know, multiply that over the number of people who are playing it. It's intensely disrespectful, in my view at least, of... Again, the developer's time and effort that they put into these games. It's like, do you mean to tell me that the cost of a beer, or I mean, even in the case of like, I mean, inevitably, if the price goes up to $9.99, even with a 30% discount at the start, you're going to have people say it's like, you know, oh, it was better when it was like $7.99 or whatever. Or sorry, actually, I'm talking about Canadian prices, so I might be messing it up here. But I'm like, is a one latte for, you know, for the week, are you trying to tell me that that's not what this game is worth, the extra content is worth? People have a very, very strange idea about what games are worth nowadays. And in one sense, it's good for me as a consumer because it's, you know, I get more variety, I get higher quality at lower prices. You know, this is technically a welfare improvement for me. The one thing I've never wanted to do is to turn around on a pricing decision that an indie makes and say, oh, you know, shave $2 off and then it's worth it. It's like, it's, they don't just pull, so far as I can tell, and I think you guys can see in chat, they don't just pull magic numbers out of the hat. Anyways, let's see. And yeah, sorry guys, I should be saying, I'm looking at the Canadian price right now, and I know the Canadian dollar isn't what it used to be, so I see $7.79. Did we get a link to Steam inside here? Tell you what guys, I'm just going to take a sec. You miss out on the music, but let me bring it up, because they've been very generous with their time, and in fact giving me the key for that matter. So, Breaking Wheel. Soundtrack's available, by the way, for the princely sum of $1.09. There's a link, folks. We're planning, but then we weren't planning on 4 more months of debt. Yeah, exactly. Our 7.0 sun more or less full since July. Money import was almost zero. Goal was to do something that you could do on your own time. Money input from you is a few grand. Yeah. Yeah, well, this is the big, I mean, so Insane Mind, probably a lot of people kind of know my background already. Like, I'm an economist. So whenever I think of costs, I always think of costs in terms of, you know, what you're giving up to do it. And as I say, your time is valuable, right? Like, I'm pretty sure if you weren't developing this game, you would be either working for someone at a, I mean, these skills definitely command a price, or you'd probably be moving into a slightly more lucrative industry and earning there. So the time commitment is not just time, it's also foregone wages, for at least in my view. Oh, that's really good of you, especially because music is certainly tough. And I mean, I really like the soundtrack, so they get a very, very small cut from game sales, but a lot from the OST. It was a way to help them out. Yeah, I think that's the right call. I mean, so I think bigger games should sort of... Oh, by the way, guys, I am looking for what you would like our Breaking Wheel to transform into. I'm partial to the cheese wheel, but I can be convinced otherwise. But yeah, so like, I really like it when, let's say, Fraxis, you know, will release the, you know, actually the outstanding Beyond Earth soundtrack for free. But I mean, that their profits are more or less preordained. I mean, Civ 6 has been released for a couple of months and is in the platinum tier of the, you know, of the best-selling games in the previous... Oh, the Tron wheel looks cool. Clockworks need to. Millionaire! And because I'm incompetent, we don't have enough for the Wheel of Duty, but... But yeah, definitely, you know, being able to throw something back to the composers in the form of the purchases, I think, is the right call. Yeah, same mind. I mean, so this is one of the reasons why I've never kind of considered going into... Is there a difference between the two jack-o'-lanterns? So we've got this one, which is kind of obscured by the lock. Looks like they cost the same, and actually looks like it's the same wheel. But yeah, I mean, I don't know how to price myself, so it's one of the things that's actually kept me from kind of going into business for myself. Oh, wait, hang on, I think maybe the edges look different? Yeah, so there's spikes on the ends. I don't know, Insane, I mean, if you think of the big locks, it could be like a metaphor for early access. You know, you never know whether or not the developer is going to finish it, and if you're getting a lemon or not. Wait a minute, did I actually pick the... Moldy cheese wheel. Noir cheese wheel. Unto us a child is born, cheese wheel. So real moldy cheese wheel. Swiss cheese wheel. This is cute. Oh, okay, gotcha. Yeah, had to leave for a bit, so you missed a lot of the stream. How's the game been treating you so far? It's really good, OCS Winspector. As I said, I was a little skeptical at the start, although Jess has never steered me to the wrong place in terms of games. Stop. Hammer time. It's actually hit a few things that I really like about games like this. So I like that the levels, we'll watch an intro. So the hard work, I was going to say, actually the one problem with me just trying to figure stuff out is that all the good work on this level is not on display because I'm going to be a shambles through it. But yeah, so one thing I really like is how I've sort of been able to see myself like learn and get better at the game as I go by. That's a really big thing for me. I like how big the levels are, and I also sort of like how sort of my indications on where I need to go have sort of been reflected in terms of, you know, little things like, you know, having the, you know, the use of the depth. So like this game is not just, like, you're not stuck on a single plane. You do wind up being switched around when you get to certain switches, which I think is a nice touch. And it means that the 3D is more than just eye candy. Oh, man, I'm not going to remember all this. It's the Pac-Man wheel, too. But yeah, it's just OCS Inspector. I think, like, so I went in. I know I talked a little bit earlier on where I kind of like, I think my first reaction on the story side was sort of like, you know, a wheel going to get its coffee. Oh yay, the zany factor. Like I'm just a really boring guy when it comes to stuff like that. But I was also pretty clear at the start saying like that was a really unfair way to treat the game. Like if you go in with a game, I've seen a big streamer before go in with a game that I really liked called Dungeon of the Endless, and like it was obvious that they were going in with like no expecting. Damn it, I was doing well otherwise. Slow but well. And it was obvious that he was going in and had no intention whatsoever of giving the game a chance. Just constant little snipey shit, like, you know, oh, this game's too smart for me and stuff like that. And like for me, it was really off-putting. Like I already was invested on the game. But I think there's a certain, oh, Jesus. All right. Sorry, chicken. At least you're very tasty now. Yeah, I think there's a certain point where if you're going to stream a game, you have to give like at least some benefit of the doubt. Like even if, you know, even if I want to be boring in my own time, I shouldn't be, you know, I shouldn't be kind of nitpicking at all the trivial stuff. Because I mean, let's just assume for a second that I sort of said as like, oh, wheels getting coffee, that's dumb. I would have missed out on something that has been a legitimately enjoyable hour and a half on a night where I was kind of like, I may not even stream because I really only have myself to blame for that. On a night I was not even, you know, thinking maybe even skipping streaming because it's kind of late and I have to do work tomorrow. So this is definitely one that's that really pleasant. Like, so I mean, again, whenever Jess recommends something, I usually know it'll be, you know, kind of more than. That's a really clever. Oh, I was admiring the design so much that I got my. You know what? I'm not even gonna mess with that. You know, there's usually more than stuff at the surface when Jess recommends something to me. But like every level, there's been something kind of new that kind of makes me smile or improves it. So. All right, let's just take a quick second. Sorry guys, I'm really bad at checking chat when I'm monologuing. So, wheel customization is your template character customization. You can move it almost directly into Skyline. Oh, cool. You overkilled learning some things because the goal has always been an RPG. Yeah, well, I was gonna say it was definitely very unusual for me to sort of see the bio on the website and see a platformer as the first choice. But then I suppose having a completed game is better than sort of having the most ambitious RPG that never gets made, so. A top hat on the chicken. People in the demo were bitching that there wasn't. Yeah, so damned if you do, damned if you don't, right? Like in my case, like I'm just kind of like, eh, it's, I'm picking up. Why do you need a story for platforms? I mean, the story of Mario exists basically in what you read in the manual, which, by the way, says that all those blocks that you're breaking are apparently like the Toadstool people. Yeah, you can see I really love Mario calling them the Toadstool people. And I think the only like story stuff that you will get in the first game would be, sorry, Mario, our princess is in another castle, basically. I mean, that game's fun. I was never like, what? But I just need to know Mario's inner motivation. But yeah, so I mean, this is easy for me, right? I can sit back and I can snipe because I'm a guy who sits down and plays video games poorly for strangers, not knowing that there's been feedback from people saying, I need a story. I just don't understand why this wheel's doing what it does. All right, have a great one, Johnny, big time. Thanks a lot for stopping by. It was a lot of fun watching you. And guys, if you haven't followed Johnny Big Time, he's currently doing Dragon's Dogma. We're talking a lot about RPGs in here, so I have to mention that. Outstanding caster. Please consider checking him out. He's more fun to watch. And he actually plays the game the whole time rather than stops and just gives his opinions. Mario Kart chasing girlfriend who doesn't know how to lock the door at night. Takes a lot of drugs, so she's probably better off without him. All right. Boom, boom, basin. I have not used name intensifies. I did. Sorry, I don't want to. Run! I played the original Divinity, Original Sin. Original Divinity. Okay, so it's not the original Divinity Original Sin because there was a Divinity game before it, but I have played Divinity Original Sin on stream before with Yip, a good friend of this cast, although I don't think he's been around lately. But it's a very good RPG. Username intensifies. Kite, how are you doing? Not a problem at all. Your sleeping schedule terrifies me, Kite, but while we are at it, and I am spending so much time directing you good people to people who are actually entertaining, guys, please do consider checking out Kite. I think you should be able to give yourself a shout out. But Kite is one of the nicest casters that I've met on Twitch. He has given so much support to various games. He's given support to streamers that I have a great respect for. He is an absolutely charming and very thoughtful, very kind man. Also has a good cast. It's not just, I was gonna say you can be a dick and be a good caster. But fortunately, Kite's, I always like to, oh Jesus Christ. I did such a good job of dodging that the first time. All right, you know what? Screw you. Oh, all right then. Oh, come on. All right. Yeah, I see the message now. Insane mind game. Let's see if I can. I felt like I was able to make some progress on this. Ooh. No. All right, let's reset the level. Also, you love Shadow Tactics? Yeah, Kite, I just pointed you to the game. Anyways, guys, if you want the biggest reason to check out Kite, he is one of the best co-casters I've seen. He can cast with anybody and make them look like a professional. So definitely he's one of the people I would definitely one of the people I would recommend checking out. Relatively new to isometric CRPGs of yesteryear, is introduced to the genre thanks to Pillars of Eternity. I actually hated reading before playing that game, and Original Sin looks similar and needed an excuse to talk to me. You ramble a lot, sorry about that. Not a problem at all, username intensifies. Obviously I've been playing Tyranny, courtesy of Paradox. They also made, Pillars of Eternity. So if you're... Okay, you know what? I kind of get it now. I think probably if I'd been paying attention a little bit more to the behavior of the rocks when I blow them up, I might have got the push. Oh, Backspace is Hawk. Thank you. But yeah, I've definitely been enjoying that. And I'm definitely interested in trying... Okay, I get it. So the arrow is trying to point me to the rock. Get wrecked, nerd. Oh my. Did I just screw myself? No, I think I'm okay. But yeah, I really liked Divinity Original Sin. Like the little bit that I played with Yip, it's a lot bigger than I can manage. I think probably after I finish Tyranny, it might be the next one that I go on to. Or I might double back, because I haven't finished Pillars of Eternity yet. But the other thing too, username intensify. This is... Oops, breaking... Oh yeah, actually, Jess is doing a better job selling it. If you are interested in some of those classic games, so obviously I really like the Shadowrun series. We've done almost all of... No, we've done... So we've done the two most recent ones on cast. I've played all three privately. I might actually do Shadowrun Returns as like a... Maybe a bonus stream sometime. But if you like old school stuff like that, definitely you should check out some of the classics as well. So for instance, Planescape Torment and Baldur's Gate are two really good examples. And of course, to speak to my own mercenary goals, if you use the GOG link down below, you'll get them at the same... Oh, bombs out of stock. Should have paid attention. You will... basically, you can pick those up at a good price, and they will... hopefully, I don't kill myself on this thing. It's a very quiet bomb. All right. Because I'm clever. Ah, sacre bleu. Yeah, that's not going to happen. Yes, well, I was busy talking about my cleverness. I was going to get the bomb to blow this up, but let's face it, the chicken wouldn't have made it anyway. But yeah, anyways, so if you like stuff like that, I definitely think you'd like to check out Torment. There's also, they're making a new one, Torment Tides of Numenaria, I believe. I really did the worst of all worlds there. And apparently, I don't know... Help! Help! Oh god, this is such a bad decision! I don't know how to catch on, I know I was supposed to ride the bear there, I just... Oh, Jesus, this is so bad! Alright, let's restart. Here I am busy trying to sell up GOG. I'd probably suggest you want to check out the original Interplay game before you... before you play the remake, just because I think it's easier to miss stuff that you don't have. But it is, I believe, as close as they can get to the original team covering it now, so... You select transparency until you realize nobody was seeing you anymore. How's it going, Millie Thale? you played Icewind Dale 1 and 2, Baldur's Gate 1 and 2, Planescape Torment, Wasteland. Oh yeah, so you pretty much got it all down. Only other thing I would add to that would be the original Neverwinter Nights, which I remember really enjoying. At this point, I think I should probably be learning more. I should probably be learning more about CRPGs from you at this point. Actually, it's also worth mentioning, if you haven't, I think the Wasteland 3 Kickstarter is already done, but they might have like the late arrival kind of award, like what I did with BattleTech, where I just wasn't aware of the new Kickstarter. See, I know how to not land on spikes. Sacre bleu! I don't know why I just watched it to kill myself. Oh, Jesus. I'm sorry, guys. It's the hour is getting to me. But yeah, so in the case of BattleTech, I wanted to participate in the Kickstarter, but unfortunately I was neglectful. But they did open sort of later, like, you know, kind of the late arrivals. I think they call them like reinforcements or something like that. Did they really make 3 million? That's outstanding. I mean, Wasteland 2 is very well done. That's one I've been meaning to do on stream, but the only problem... The only problem for me with those games is I do all of the dialogue, and clearly I don't do games quickly. Oh, I was reading chat. I swear, I'm good at these games. No. Yeah, so Insane Mind, I will say, all right, you know what? Maybe I can, like, jump. Nope, this was a bad idea. How am I gonna, okay, let's just accept that this is gonna suck for a little bit. How the hell am I gonna do this? I know I need to break this wall. Oh, really? I was going to try, Oh, the game needs a reset because of the sounds. Okay. I will start up the game. I like the sounds. And, I mean, music actually kind of makes games like this. So. Where are we? Anyways, so Elkanu does some of the best. It seems like you're pretty diligent at catching streamers doing it. But if you get a chance to see Elkanu's playthrough of this, even if he's a French caster, so I don't know how your French is. Mine's terrible. But his reactions to things going wrong are amazing. So if you want to see Full Tilt. You definitely should check out his playthrough of it when he gets to it. I am just bad. And thank you for saying so, username intensifies. Clearly, I didn't have anything. Oh, okay. That was nice of that to get out of the way. But yeah, obviously, I didn't have anything to do with bringing this into the world, but I know probably. With this game impending release and currently in early access, I have a feeling that the dev is going to be hearing more about things people don't like than what they do. Get a move on, you fool. There we go. But yeah, so as you probably already know, we've got the developer inside of the chat, so it's nice to give credit where credit is due in terms of the pitches, because I really like them too. You've got French, Spanish, German, Dutch, Norwegian, Finnish on the team. Conveniently, the languages that the game will be localized in. And Scottish, because that should count, you think. Peter Sellers did a really wonderful radio skit on the different accents of the UK. The Scottish part is outstanding, especially when he delivers this wonderfully deadpan. So he winds up meeting sort of a Scottish hotel manager or something like that. He's like, "Ah, pour your wee dram and make your porridge sandwich." And you know, at the end of this really, you know, boisterous but just utterly incomprehensible greeting, this professor character he's playing just deadpans, I expect to have that translated later today. just keep in mind, username intensifies, you have to earn a certain number of coins to get the cheese wheel. Or you can use the cheat code, which involves pop culture references I don't understand. Oh yeah, well, I mean, in Say My Games, like, it's, I think, you, first of all, you're absolutely right in terms of quality. And bugs. I can actually remember, so there's an indie I really liked. It's kind of like the spiritual successor to Syndicate. Oh, I'm fucked. Called Satellite Rain. And it seems like for them, they put a lot of effort into the look of the game. Like, it was just this beautiful, like, rain and neon kind of cyberpunk world. Really, really attractive. All right. I was trying to get away. The wall. Please don't blow me up. I got blowed up. But anyway, so when I took a look at the early, I almost didn't buy this game because of it. It was actually Elkanu was the one who wound up kind of making me buy it. But like every review I read basically made it seem like it was just this early access puff. With all visuals, no gameplay, and then I think like the August before it was released, all of the reviews suddenly started turning positive, and they were talking about, I was like, you know, the AI may be a little goofy at points, but this is like, this is a fun game now. And again, like, the thing that I love about this, I mean, it's obviously very, it's pretty much done. So at this point, it's more kind of a matter of polish. But one of the things I like about this is, like, there's a game. It's not, I'm not recommending this, or I'm not, you know, buying this game on the hope that one day, you know, the dev gets its act together and finishes it. It's like, you know, this is what it is. You can buy it. You can, incidentally, guys, if there's a price increase coming, now you can actually get it for less. And I mean, the fact that it's moddable obviously gives it the long tail in terms of the replayability. But again, this is one of the things that I like. It's every time I'm ready to just throw my hands up and say I'm never doing early access again, something like this comes along, which is kind of like, oh, they're actually treating the customer with respect. This is so they can get some feedback on things that are going wrong, and, you know. And then I'm consigned to playing about 100 other really crappy games that are just trying to make a quick buck. So. Boss level 5. Okay, this might be the last level that I do, guys, because I do need to get some sleep. But if it's a big boss fight, it'll probably take me a long time. So, to be fair, we hate the customers, but it's the only way that you make the game better, to get the feedback and find bugs, so you're stealth respecting them. All right, guys. So, with that in mind, if you want to support someone who hates you, buy this, and then be sure to throw some of that sweet, sweet dollar my way, too. Because I hate all 10 of you. Oh my god, we got double digits. This is such a proud moment for me, guys. You know what? I'm going blind into this. Double jump. I see no substantial challenge with this boss now that I have double jump. Holy cow! See? Double jump makes you immortal. If you really want to make System Chalk hate you, backseat him. If I was smarter, I would have actually started recording followers at the beginning of every cast, just so I can watch those numbers crash down on Crusader Kings Night. Ah! Love the pace of this, not having Windows, you won't be able to play it. And you can't put it on your wishes. Oh, Jesus. Alright, I'm just bad. Double jump doesn't help when you have to go on the ground, my. All right. Mistakes were made. First door unlocked. Hello, Captain Bear. How are you doing? We are currently playing Breaking Wheel by Insane Mind Games, which may or may not have any relation to the Insane Game. Sorry, Insane Mind Games in chat. It's actually somebody who's a little. Crowbarrow1, thank you very much for following the Worst Camless stream on Twitch. I need better ad copy. Jess, how much do your services cost? If you could start selling this stream as on the basis of the green eyes and sexual charisma, I think we could make beautiful music together. Thank you very much for the follow, Crowbar. Tip's hat better be a fedora. Also because of Linux support. It's a neckbeard joke. Double neckbeard joke. Just like this double jump. Excellent. That couldn't have gone any better. All right, I'm speaking nonsense. Linux is a different ballpark and certain things may be lost, but you should be able to adapt it. I have a problem that people buy you games from your wish list, you end up with Windows games that you can't play. Oh, that sucks, Millie. I used to, actually, when this stream started, I was a Mac-only gamer. Because I'd gotten, like, the laptop. I got on the laptop for a research project I was kind of doing over the summer, and it was the only thing I had for game. Like it was a well specced out computer, but obviously it was a, you know, is very limited in terms of what I could do. But yeah, it sucks just because you had to. I mean, I didn't have a problem of people buying me stuff I couldn't play. Well, this is going to make the boss fight interesting. All right, let's just take a quick look here. Sorry, guys, I just wanted to take a quick look. Depends on the game. Depends on the game and the coverage you think you can get. Not a Mac lover, but your travel cut you down to one computer and you've had... Yeah, so, like, my view on the whole Mac, Android, Windows, Linux, iOS, BlackBerry, because I'm Canadian? Okay, I'm going to shut up and let the game talk for a bit. Hello, Master Troll. All right, so I see a big boom box up there. All right, so I'm pretty sure I'm going to just have to jump on his head and drop a bomb on him. Well then. So $47. Jess, if you could make me famous for my green eyes and sexual charisma, I'll very happily pay the requisite. I will, you know what, tell you what, 50 cents will make it even, because we don't have pennies in Canada anymore. Anyways, yeah, so I was going to say, I have my preferences, but my view is that Apple, Google, or Linus Torvalds can pay me to evangelize for their platform. And with the stunning coverage I've been giving here, I expect them to beat down the doors and come for me. Yeah, my guess here would be, I have a feeling Elkanu, I mean, especially because Elkanu knows you, Jess, I'm almost certain he'll cover that relatively soon, and he will react a lot better than I do to sudden, how do I put it? Like sudden, disasters. Don't evangelize for any platform. They all have their place. Well, the way it works, Jess, so for those of you who want to know, so before Canada got rid of its putty, they actually, the Bank of Canada did some studies. So if you want to know exactly the things they're worried about, so inflation was a concern that they had, for instance. Yes, instead of talking about the boss fight, I'm going to talk about inflation caused by getting rid of the penny. Deal with it, nerds. Just giving away the coins. So they, you know what? This was actually poorly considered because I should have saved those for the oncoming boss fight. But you know what? I am so confident in my ability to double jump to safety and not hit the fire. Yep, didn't waste those coins at all. So anyways, so they put a lot of thought into it, how they make it non-inflationary, how do you make sure that people are able to work in the new environment. So basically, cash transactions are rounded. I believe if it's the 3 cents, it's rounded down to the nearest sort of tenth. Or no, I guess it would be the nearest 5 cents. No, I'm pretty sure it's the nearest tenth. And if it's above three, or if it's three, or yeah, I think if it's above three, then you round up. And if it's an electronic transaction, like a credit or a debit purchase or something like that, then it's the sticker price. And obviously, most people are using electronic means of payment. You know who doesn't use electronic means of payment? Drug dealers. So. Yeah, it's exactly the reason we got rid of it. While the rest of the world is dealing with genuine austerity measures, one of our austerity measures was getting rid of the penny. Oh God, whatever will I do? And then a bunch of idiots are like hanging on to pennies, thinking that they're going to become worth like $1 million as a historical. Oh, for God's sake. All right. Oh, I blew it. All right. So, attack number one. Oops, that's up. Oh. So I'm squandering my double jump, I think. Wait a minute. Okay, so I actually have to manually jump it. Okay, cool. You couldn't hit the broadside of a barn. I gotta start. Okay, so I gotta start the jump before it lands on the ground, otherwise I'm not gonna be able to control myself. I'm almost tempted to use the cheat, but I'm gonna take my lumps and... Oh no, that was just bad luck. I'm gonna win this through my sheer force of will. Oops. God mode activated, press delete to remove. Nope. I was invited to God mode. Okay. Come on, you can't make me lose the respect of my audience. They come here for leak games by a professional gamer. Well, this is a sticky situation. Yeah. I kind of like how the early troll attacks also give you a bit of an indication in terms of how it affects you. If the dev says cheat, nope. We played Dark Souls with no walkthroughs, no guides, no nothing. Wrong way. Ah, crap. Oh, this won't let me out. Well, sort of. All right, I'm gonna deal with this, the left-hand side first, because I know I take more damage doing that. I want to have a moddable so anybody can cheat. It's the American dream, isn't it? One day you too can become a scam artist and probably president. Mods, could you please time Jesse out for using all capitals? So I've sort of learned my lesson not to squander those coffees at the close to the boss. Of course, I just simply squander them in other ways. Because I enjoy the challenge. Why am I a wheel of cheese? The real question, Jampy Dampy, is why not be the wheel of cheese? If you had been here at the start, you would have understood, man. Yeah, because a little part that's like, God, I almost got caught on something with the cheese wheel. Let's see if I can do that. Because this sounds like an entertaining way to spend the evening, right? To try and catch my cheese on, yeah. Oh, come on. Impale you on the... All right, I think you get the idea, though. All right, now if I'm not a moron... I think I'm in the easy mode for the boss. But guess what, chat? I am a moron! With a master's degree. And here I am. Using my name on the internet. Playing indie 3D platformers. Available for a mere $7.79 Canadian on Steam. It's an electronic purchase, so you don't need to worry about rounding up because of the penny. Or lack of the penny. Oh, hang on. I thought there was coffee here. Nope. All right. Well, so much for easy mode. I did take the coffee. I'm an idiot. All right. I really like the look of the Tron wheel, actually. Talking a snowman wheel. Oh, because right, missed it over Christmas. All right, oh, don't tell me there's a Tron level. I need to go to bed. I'm gonna get fired. Well, GG guys, beat the boss. Just how I roll, guys. Melithael, the boss just was so intimidated by my, you know, by my talent. I thought it was clever, Jess. Chat, if you thought it was clever, donate $5 to prove it wrong. If you thought it wasn't clever, donate $10 to cancel out the goodwill of the other ones. That was dumb of me. Alright, well. Probably just as well that I actually consume as little coffee as possible on these areas, just because I keep losing them in stupid and inefficient ways. So. Or, you know, I could just try and do the boss properly and not take advantage of being hopped up on coffee beans. I'm sorry, guys. I'm really bad at speaking right now. Ninja upgraded the engine for 4.14 to... Oh, from 4.1 to... I was like... Lower number doesn't usually mean it got upgraded. Week before earlier access took forever to clean up the mess. This one actually seems like it's sticking around. Coffee doesn't equal double jumps. It's actually the... Lack of a better word is good. Thank you, Jess.
It was clever. He.
But yeah, there's springs at the beginning of the level that give me the double jump. I think probably chat has answered that before I got to it, though, so... But it's important to remember that I am a trustworthy person of respect and consideration. I used the double jump inadvertently. I have lost so much coffee because of that mistake. Thank you very much for the donation, Jess. But you do realize that with that $5 donation, you are now actually at a deficit of, what is it? Say 47? Assuming that it was 47 cents, you're at a deficit of $4.53 or something like that. Bad part is you're pretty sure that we 100% all your levels, so it's definitely doable. Don't think you will ever 100% each other's levels because you suck at it too. Now that's a box quote right there, really. 23 coffee? Child's play. Child's play. I'm just sorry that the boss... I was too scared to show up when I had the appropriate level of coffee. Well, Crowbar, you gotta get, like, the little hunk of cheese out somehow, right? You paid the processing fee, if that's what you mean. Oh, so it's like a full $5 deficit for you, then. That's one thing that I don't... Like, I kind of wish they'd actually give you credit for paying a processing fee. I realize it would give, like, weird numbers... although I suppose it's kind of fun, like, I don't really care. I appreciate the donation no matter what. Oh, god damn it. But, like, especially for you, Jess, where I know people are kind of, like, going on these giant, you know, oh, we're gonna break Jesse Quill guys kinds of donation sprees. I'd be interested to see who, like, you know, wants to play the big man in front of chat in terms of their... Alright. Let's make it... Oh, god damn it! Oh, I did it. I did it, Reddit. That was really unkind. 0 out of 10. At this point, I'm not cheating just for the sake of spiting you all. But yeah, anyways, I absolutely love it when I see, you know, people playing the big man in chat. By the way, guys, I'm a mod for Jessie Quill, so I can completely talk like a complete asshole about her cast. I am her biggest trolling problem in the cast. But yeah, I love it when people play the big man on cast, and I would love to take a look at your donations. I'm going to keep those in reserve. Which is actually really weird now that I think about it, because technically, I mean, it's not like I have more or less, like, obviously if I don't get hit, I'm going to have the same amount of coffee if I collect them all at once or otherwise, but I feel I kind of just get a little reckless when I have lots of resources, so. I don't think this goes away on its own. But yeah, anyways, I just really kind of like to see how many people want to play big for the chat but don't actually bother supporting with the processing fee, because it's too expensive. You have yet to ever beat him? Oh, just unlocked to the Tron. Okay, I see what you're saying. Yeah, I'll, so does the Tron level require coins, or does it require, like, being, like, winning? If it requires winning, then I'll probably just wimp out and do the terrible deed. Wait, so Jess, as in like paid the fee? That's hilarious if that's true. I mean, it sucks for you, because that's actually a lot of money that you're paying, but you can unlock levels of coins, okay. Well, tell you what, actually the one cheat I'm willing to maybe do would be to unlock the extra coins. Because I still actually need to win the mechanics of that boss fight, and it saves me from like doing all this repetition, although I suspect that would like lower my coffee over time and I would have a lot more difficulty with the battle. I don't know, we'll see how this round goes. Yeah, that makes sense. I'm also occurring, like, I didn't, you know, as much as I love playing this game, I wasn't given this key out of the goodness of everyone's heart. Like, I should be showing off the game. All right. I mean, I'll do one more legit attempt on the boss, and then I'll cheat like the dirty rat I am. Yeah, Crowbar, I'm gonna give one more legitimate try on this, and then I'll move into cheat mode. Don't hit it back, you fuck. Yeah. Only untold number of those to go. Oh, fuck you! No, 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 you're going to him. I thought that was four. Alright. Alright, that was a mistake. Oh, that was unlucky. Saved it. Oh, get back there. Easy. I'd like to dedicate that win to all you jackasses telling me to cheat. Sorry. All right. So, sorry, Insane Mind, just click the level to unlock it for the 115 levels. So what was the Tron level? Robo Wars, maybe? Fort Grimmage for the opener. Master Control, okay, cool. That's a really nice looking level. It's also neat too, so like we've had enough time to sort of get into the game and sort of learn how it works. So with the boss level, you know, we've been introduced with the springs. I already see those added inside here, so you're kind of building up your toolbox as you go through the you know, through the experience. And as you say, apparently the last few levels are going to be exciting. And on, I mean, insanely, look, I'll be honest with you. If I made something that looks like this, I would be doing a lot more self-fapping. So once upon a time in a previous life, I used to work in motion pictures as a camera cameraman. So I have a special place in my heart for good lighting. All right, we'll see how long we last, and then we'll run headlong into the Tron level, and then I'm going to bed because I left a whole bunch of fairly important work to do early in the morning. And while I suspect I could get away from showing up a little later than I have the last couple of days, I don't want whoever's relying on that data to sort of like come in and not have it 100% ready. So Jess, you are always very well lit, at least according to the totally hot private photos I get of her, chat. That's totally something real that happens, okay? I am indeed what some might call a player of the game. Login T, thank you very much for that auto host. If you are up at this hour, God help you. Sorry guys, this commentary has pretty much been garbage for the past, 2 hours? But I'm actually really enjoying this. So here's a question for you, Insane Mind Games. I noticed the I noticed that when you haven't initiated the jump, you don't get the double jump. I'm assuming that was a conscious decision that was made, correct? Well, in Sane Mind Games, it's mostly just so I get a chance to shout you out and say thank you for hosting me. But everybody, as your leader, the disembodied voice telling you this isn't going to go away, what is what, and how many, like, mad Snapchats he gets from the m'ladies, I order you to follow Insane Mind Game. No, if you, we can probably do something along those lines for giving out some support. Ah, that makes sense. I mean, it's not completely indefensible, right? Like, obviously, it says double jump. Like, it... Oh, for fuck. Go away. Like, clearly, double jump implies that there was a jump in the first place. So if I'm in the middle of the air, like, that's, why am I such a moron? It was more just kind of a curiosity thing, so. How many other m'ladies do I have? 0.47? Where were you during the boss fight? Could have used you. Oh yeah, I've also completely given up I wonder if there's a chicken in the boss level. Alright. Fort Grimmage is now I know I was just supposed to do the intro, but meh. Alright. I think it is time that we spend some of these hard-earned coins. Sorry you were helping Jeff. Or do we mean something in this? Sorry, I think I missed some of the, I think I missed some important information in those messages. Jess, I don't understand. Complete the previous... No. Sorry. I know you guys said somewhere how to buy a level. Master control. Just click a level to unlock it. I don't think that's where unlock an or. Oh, gotcha. Okay. If at first you don't succeed, get good. I have to make it to the boss. All right. Well, you know what? Just for a second, with due respect to the composers. Just for a minute. this is a mistake! I have a friend who worked on this. Oh, I keep going for the double jump that doesn't exist. Run, little buddy!
Yes!
Yeah, so I think... I can't remember if he was the digital imaging technician or if he was the, I thought that was a button. Wait, so this doesn't do anything? Sacre bleu! Throw a disc at the button. How do I... Oh! Oh! Oh. Anyways, yeah, so I can't remember if he was digital imaging technician or camera operator. I'm pretty sure he was a B camera operator. Anyways, I got to watch the movie with him in IMAX. It was really cool. And by really cool, I mean a very long and expensive Daft Punk music video. Moving up and down. Oh, here we go.
Wow, bam, bam.
I am unstoppable. You know, someone that worked on this cool guy, bit of an obsession with Poppy, though. How long is this damn song? I want to go back to the composers who... Love that movie, not least of all, because you can spot a bunch of the Vancouver locations in it. Yeah, absolutely, Frantic Whisper. We were busy, like, we were talking during half the movie about all the shooting stuff. He also worked on Watchmen, actually. He did, like, a bunch of the Dr. Manhattan scenes, because he's really good at, one, 3D, and two, he's also really good at, sacre bleu! He's also really good at, So he's good at 3D, good at digital. I originally met him on a little indie film called Battlestar Galactica. All right, let's get the real music back. So guys, let me introduce to you a delightful caster, Frantic Whisper. He is also somebody who works in the game industry. So as you may have noticed, Frantic, we've got the developer of All right, I'm a little stumped. I'm probably just not thinking straight, though. Or maybe I just need to shoot one of these things down. Oops. Anyways, so Frantic Whisper is somebody who doesn't have a regular casting schedule, but I strongly recommend... I'm trying to shoot the drones! Okay, I'll try one there. They have the payload. Apparently, I just can't aim. Anyway, sorry, this is a terrible shout-out for Frantic Whisper. Absolutely wonderful guy, one of the reasons I regretted moving from Vancouver. All right. I think I'm just too dumb for this. Oops. Mistakes were made. Ah, oh, come on. Okay. Focus. Focus. Oh my god, you fucked it up! Alright. Frantic Whisper works in the game industry, is the reason why we have been doing Battlefield 1, which I've been having a hell of a time with. Really outstanding guy, and in addition to having a cool job in gaming, he works in AI. Really can talk about anything. Is like, he's really... he's well-read, he's a great conversationalist, family man. I cannot say enough good things about him, and one of the reasons why I think you guys should follow him, it's, so like, having gone through school and kind of needing to live with, how do I put it, like, infrequent streaming schedules and such. Tanks, the worst kind. I realize that it's kind of a major turnoff for people potentially. Damn it! All right, I should probably turn on the cheat. But yeah, he's somebody who I've gotten a lot out of watching, and it's. I appreciate that it's almost like stream kryptonite. If you don't have a regular schedule, people don't always get a chance to see you, or they don't necessarily follow you. I definitely recommend that you follow his stream. When you do, you'll get a chance. I mean, I really loved his Extra Life stream, which maybe he'll do in 2017 as well. I got to see him play a lot of his favorite games, either ones that were, you know, favorite ones that he worked on, or ones that... you know, he just had a great love for, and one of the things that I'm really, I think, is becoming more of a common thing. Jesus Christ, I'm bad. One of the things that I think he is coming a little more common in my kind of the streams that I like watching and sort of the shoutouts that I give is the people who kind of communicate that love of gaming, and you really understand why the game is special to them. So in addition to the fact that Frantic Whisper has contributed tons of entertainment to us, either in the form of giving me another game to be bad at, or you know, through the many conversations and the you know, just being here and being such a nice guy in chat, I definitely encourage you guys to check him out and see some of the stuff that kind of informed his love and passion for gaming. That's great, and yes, I'm not a big resolution guy either, Frantic Whisper. But I mean, I'll be honest with you. Like, I have considered, even though I don't have, you know, a very burdensome streaming schedule right now, I have definitely thought about cutting back on streaming just because of what it takes up. And I don't have a family, right? So, well, I mean, like, I'm not an orphan, but like, I don't have the direct needs of a family. So, you know, I say this, but I say it sort of knowing that you've got some very important things that come up. And I mean, no problem on the donation. I said I was going to do it, right? So I would be, I'm not going to like turn around and tell people, oh yeah, you should totally donate to this guy because it saves me the trouble of doing it. I don't even know if I actually got you anything for your Extra Life, but it's a great cause. I mean, it's how I got started in streaming. And it is quite literally the least I could do. All right, we're sort of making progress. Had arguments on where the level should be because it was... Yeah, I probably should. See, the last time I was told to cheat, I'm gonna die. I got it, but I don't want to be fired. I don't know, I don't think I can actually get fired. Not really. Yeah, wonderful sound. I mean, this is one of the big ones for platformers for me, is that pretty much anyone that I've played has had a pretty solid soundtrack. And I think probably what it comes down to is, like, especially when you're playing something that has a degree of challenge. Oh, for God's sake. When you play something that has like a degree of challenge like this, I think part of it just comes down to the fact that if you have, you know, pounding techno, if you have some good music to go alongside it, you know, it keeps you in it for that extra minute. I guess I don't need to worry about preserving my life. Oh, for Christ. I always seem to get caught on the lip of these things. Alright, I think I'm just gonna sit and camp some drones for a bit. But yeah, anyways, I mean, so Geometry Dash, Slip, Super Meat Boy, all great examples of games which are certainly challenging, but I think the soundtrack plays a really big part in sort of keeping you sane. Well, you know, Spectre, when you get this game, you can download the free modding tools, and you have all the stuff that the developers use for making this game, and, can make your own Tron level. Eh? Eh? Of course, I said that before I just read Insane Mind saying all the tools and blueprints are there and we give out the entire project to anyone who buys it for modding, so I'm just gonna sound like some hack who doesn't have an original thought in his head. But that was totally my original idea. All right, in the name of progress, let's skip over. Oh, well. Hello, Master Control. Hey, this is cool. I am very glad I have God mode enabled right now. Okay, want to buy aim. Just shoot him? All right. Wee. 7 shots. I was gonna mention it, but it almost seemed like it might have been just a challenge thing, because I mean, this is a little bit later in the game, right? But I'm glad I'm not just being bitchy when I'm like, why can't I see the disc? Anyways. It's an option to add auto-aim. I'm already cheating, okay? You know, it's occurred to me, I think I've only seen the original Tron once. It's a nice touch, though. I've earned all these coins. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, this was Breaking Wheel. I know this is a little bit of a shorter cast than I normally do, but it's late at night and I have to work. Quick follow-up on the Christmas stream. I think this is what I think it is. My post office is terrible. I hate them in every possible way. But I believe the book that, or rather the collection of books that your very kind donations on Christmas have arrived. So I might be picking those up tomorrow, assuming that the post office does not find further ways to infuriate me. If I do, I will post the images on Twitter. I realize that that is probably not exciting to anybody but me, but deal with it. The very least I could do is show you the product of your hard-earned dollars. And again, thank you very much. That was very unexpected. More importantly, very special thank you to Jesse Quill for bringing this game to my attention, and Insane Mind Games for staying the entire time through it. If you guys want, I definitely recommend checking out their Twitter and their website. It's a team of Fallout 4 and Skyrim modders who have gone and started working on their own games, and it sounds like they, once they finish this one, that there's something bigger and more ambitious in mind. So definitely people who are worth checking out. Of course, it's also worth checking out the game. Here is the link for Steam. A couple things that I will recommend as before. So obviously, if you want to continue seeing games like this made, you have to support them. I would also say that one of the things that I sort of thought when I first saw the game is how in the world are they going to differentiate themselves in a ecosystem where basically everybody who's downloaded Unity or Unreal decides that they want to make a new platformer, and it makes the genre look kind of low rent by comparison. I will admit, I hedged my bets. I had like a plan B game in mind just in case this wasn't my thing, even though I have a certain trust for Jesse Quill and the recommendations that she made. Certainly did not disappoint. I played it the entire time, even if it was a shorter cast than before. I don't really do reviews, and I don't think it would be right for an early access game, but I mean, definitely if you like platforming stuff, this game definitely has some, you know, it has something of its own. The customizability is really nice, especially with the modding tools. One thing that really got my attention on it was the size of the levels, the diversity of them, the looks, the colors. Obviously, as you got to see the playthrough, it's a little, there's still a little few quirks, but like what you see is what it's like to play. Like these bugs will be taken care of. This is one of the early access titles where you're not really buying it on the promise. Like you have a fairly good idea of what you're signing up for if you pick it up. And I mean, for me, it's a fairly fair price, but as I always say, right, like I didn't have to pay for this, and it is not my intention to spend your own money for you. If you're on the fence about it, what I would definitely recommend is to either add it to your wish list or follow it, because that will show up on your Steam activity. And again, one of the difficult things, I had not heard of this game until Jess brought my attention to it. Hopefully I can pass that on to you guys, and rather than the rather unrealistic expectation of expecting you guys to go and tell like five friends, hey, I saw this game Breaking Wheel, I expect you to hold that in your head the entire day and then go check out the developer's website or the Steam store, because there's nothing else that's going to draw your attention away from it. You know, if you are interested in it, I definitely recommend doing a follow or a wish list on Steam. That will inform the other people who are on your friends list, and as a result, it, you know, on the margin, it'll matter. I don't think there's going to be like a mass of people who click because you hit follow, but if one extra person checks out the game and picks it up as a result of something like that, if it's a follow or a wish list, it's costless to you. If you pick it up, then it is, of course, the price in your local currency on Steam. I leave it to you to decide if it was the value, but this was one that definitely very pleasantly surprised me, and I naturally wish the best to the developers, because it was a lot of fun to have them inside of the chat. Anyways, let me just take a quick second follow-up on chat. Oh, show him any other. Oh, right. Frantic, are you still here? Apparently, I have to show him something other than Tron, but. Big supporters of indies. I trust you, Jess. I played it. Game dynamically reads levels and skins auto when a modder makes a level. It's just. Oh, cool. Yeah. Incidentally, guys, EA refers to early access, not Electronic Arts. Oh wait, nope. People are talking. Oh no, no. That's there's the Huawei. All right. Frantic Whisper's here. So, Frantic Whisper, who? What should we show you? You know, I kind of like Frozen Ruins, actually. Oh, hit the level. A level I haven't seen. Okay, fair enough. Well, let's take a look at the intro of the level we skipped. Here's what Glacial Folly will look like. But yeah, so this is what the bit. You don't start off as a cheese wheel, but here is Breaking Wheel in all of its glory. An anvil. Ooh. Falling icicles. I have to worry about that now that I'm in Ottawa. All the signage telling me that icicles will ruin my day and destroy everything I love. Okay, apparently this is a boring level. Oh, damn it. I should just choose level. Let's do Ice Cube. With more Skyrim houses. As you can see, we've got coffee and mountains. Another boring level. Hammer time? As you can see, cinder block hammers, coins, archways, axes, chests, and I'm not just talking about the angel statue. Behold the glory that is Breaking Wheel and fire. I still haven't seen Doctor Who. Thank you. And here is my cheese wheel. Anyways, lads and ladies, I already said my goodbyes. Let's see who I can host. I'm now going to abruptly dump the cast into another streamer. You can all... Oh, guys, I have not had a chance to host this guy in forever. So we have got Melee Mage. He's only got a couple people in the channel right now. He's playing Diablo 3. Not a problem at all in Insane Mind Games. That was a lot of fun to play. And I do mean it when I say all the best with your game. I do not envy the economics of your industry, but there is very clearly a lot of attention and passion that went into this, and I'm certainly looking forward to seeing what you guys get up to. But please finish Breaking Wheel first so I can play the rest of it. We've got Melee Mage. I originally wanted to just say go away, but I would love it if you guys could come along with a rage for me. He's playing Diablo 3, and you get a chance to see the man who has bought me so many drinks at EXP. And is really fun to have hang out and cast. So the way we normally do raids is to say we're tired of system talk, heard this place was better. That is not a typo, by the way. That is how he spells his name. He will be fine if you copy and paste that in there. And I'd love it if you guys can take a quick peek, see if it's your kind of thing. I mean, as is the case with indies, right? The best we can really ask is for a chance to entertain you. If it's not your kind of thing, obviously there's no way that we're going to be able to make a cast something that it's not, but I think the best thing that a caster can always ask for is the chance to see if it is something up for you. So I'm going to hang out there for a couple minutes like I always do, and then I will drop off into unconsciousness, and I will dream of all the shuffling that I need to do and privacy concerns and just generally not ruining the Statistics Act. Anyways, have a great one, everybody. Thanks a lot, and we will see you next time.